Boom. At 8:20 a.m. local time on October 26, 2025, the Taal Volcano south of Manila in the Philippines produced an unusually powerful explosive eruption. The eruption plume initially rapidly shot upwards at speeds as high as 418 miles per hour or 673 kilometers per hour, quickly reaching peak heights of 2100 meters or about 6900 feet. The many large boulders ejected to such heights would then take a full 20 and a half seconds to fall back to the ground, leaving vapor trails as they fell before impacting. Simultaneously, superheated volcanic material too dense to rise in the buoyant column of hot air collapsed back to the ground, generating a radial series of pyroclastic surges which would have burned everything organic they touched. These expanded outwards at speeds of between 34 and 40 miles per hour or 55 to 64 kilometers per hour, eventually going over the Taal Volcano's central crater rim in some spots, mainly via lower parts of the existing crater walls, and then descending beyond that a short distance. These surges likely reached about 3 square kilometers, thankfully remaining completely confined to the unpopulated and completely off-limits central Taal Island. As the eruption plume subsequently drifted to the southwest, volcanic lapilli rained down for a short time. What had just occurred was known as a phreatomagmatic eruption, caused when shallow magma directly contacted the bottom of the crater lake. This caused a rapid expansion of adjacent lake water to steam, generating tremendous pressure and then a powerful explosion, which ejected some fresh bits of lava despite the lack of obvious orange-red fragments in the aforementioned footage. Yet, this was not the first eruption to occur in that particular 24-hour time span, just the largest of the four eruptions which occurred between October 25th and October 26th. The first phreatomagmatic eruption at 5:21 p.m. on the 25th had a moderate size, being followed by a significantly smaller phreatic eruption, essentially the same process but without any direct magma contact and instead only indirect heating by underlying magma to the crater lake at 2:55 a.m. on the 26th. A moderate-sized phreatomagmatic explosion followed at 8:13 a.m., and after that 2-minute-long eruption ended, a 4-minute-long large phreatomagmatic explosion followed at 8:20 a.m. When combined, these closely timed explosions might seem quite frightening or concerning, but I, as a geologist, am here to tell you that in my opinion, if you aren't specifically on Taal Island or on a boat in Taal Lake, you have nothing to worry about. But how can I say this? Simple. Unlike after the deadly 2020 eruption where the ground on sections of all of Taal Island had been slowly rising, since December 2024 that uplift turned into subsidence with only highly localized and temporary swelling. In other words, no new magma is currently rising, with the subsidence in part being triggered by some of the shallow underlying magma slowly cooling. Thus, the magma that has powered all of Taal's eruptions since last December has been from the very minor leftover magma at fairly shallow depths beneath the volcano. Now, this magma could still be capable of producing more similarly sized phreatic or phreatomagmatic eruptions like we just witnessed on October 25th and 26th. However, like I said, there isn't all that much magma that could be potentially expelled, so there, in my opinion, should be no chance at the present or in the near future of any type of larger eruption resembling Taal's deadly 2020 subplenian eruption. While that 2020 eruption, rated on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 4, the latest October eruption would only register in as a low end 2, in other words, more than 100 times smaller than the 2020 eruption. And, while yes, that 2020 eruption was also preceded by ground subsidence, that pattern turned into strong uplift many months before the eruption started, something which has not happened at the present as Taal continues to subside slightly. In other words, while Taal does have the potential to possibly inconvenience nearby residents with minor ashfall or lapilli fall, it currently does not seem to pose any other threat. That of course assumes that everyone follows the 5 Volks recommendations on what areas to stay out of, especially since these types of eruptions occur with little or no warning. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, MarkG388, for supporting my work.